I'm here with Manjunath Murthy, who is the chief arbiter of the National Premier Blind. Manjunath, which national premier is this for you at the blind event?
This is for me seventh one.
Seventh time
yeah. I'm doing nationally. From 2009, I'm involved in blind chess.
Okay.
I worked for an open tournament. It was conducted in Coimbatore first. But previously, I was conducted a South Zone tournament and one more state blind tournament in the Karnataka. Later, once I joined with the ASFB, Mr. Swapnil and Charudath called me for Coimbatore tournament. There, I met Charu and Swapnil. And thereafter, I'm involved for this Blind Chess Association.
So, you can be called as the most experienced blind chief arbiter in India?
Yeah. Proudly, I can say, because I like to work here. I like to serve. I can't say work. I like to serve here. Because, see, for sighted normal people, many arbiter will be there. They can do, and there is no challenge, sir. If number of entries are more and work is more, then we need assistants, help, arbiters will be there. But here, there is a problem of sponsorship and like this type. So they will call me and they will tell, if need only, we will give you assistant, otherwise you have to manage. Then I will say, if you have volunteers, then I can manage. Otherwise, if number of entries 100, 120, if like that, then I'll ask for one or two assistant arbiters, qualified arbiters. That time they will arrange, otherwise I'll manage alone.
What are the challenges in the blind chess as compared to normal chess for an arbiter?
See, this is a national premier here, okay, many are know how to play chess and what is pairing. When we are conducting open tournament, then there we have to call each and every one player and take them to seat and arrange them.
So if there are 120 people,
yeah,
you have to do it for all?
Yeah, we have to do it because many of don't know who is playing white, who is playing black and where is their table number. And they have to find, it's not very easy to find out there for their tables. So we have to take them and even we have to tell them, he is your opponent. So meet him first, these work we have to do, then later there may be parallel boards, many are using parallel boards, then there may be announcement problem, or while moving the pieces they will lift some piece and they are going to move some other piece, so that time we have to be very careful. And while totally and partially are playing, there we will get a bit difficult, but many totally they don't know how to announce, they are using their personal boards, that time we have to ask them to touch opponent board. Even you have to use the parallel boards, so you use it and then confirm your move and then play. Here also you can see from one or two games, here also there is a missing of moves because of that announcement. And even many of don't know what is ABC, file and ranks, they don't know. So, and many clock for regarding time pressure, when they come to time pressure, when less than 2 minutes or 3 minutes, then we have to tell them every 1 minute. Mm. So these are very challenging for us.
So two things I noticed is, once when an opponent calls out a move, say rook e1, if the opponent hears it as rook b1, then it causes problem because there is a different position on both the boards.
Yeah, then we'll go to back first and we'll ask the player and what they're recorded. We have to check the recorded. If both are recorded as per there, then whose turn to play? That time what he said and what he recorded, we are going to according to that. Otherwise, what happens sometimes, rook k b1 and both are in same rank, then rook b1 they will announce, we don't know which rook is on b1, so that time we'll again we have to set the board, both the boards, then we have to check properly and then we have to ask both the players. If it is okay, both are agreed, we allow them to continue from there. If one agreed, if both are agreed that rook b1 is okay, but we know which one, so then we clear the position defects. And then we'll ask the players to, if necessary, because time, and they are going to lose their time also, we'll adjust the clocks and then we'll ask them to play.
And in time pressure, you have to be constantly moving from one board to the other, looking at the times.
Those who are working for visually challenged, they have to move, and it's very necessary because many of them don't know, even though partial can't see the clocks. We can keep the normal clock only we are using in open tournaments and like this, because here only seven. Actually, they were having 10 clocks, but only 3 is now working. So, only nationally we are using that one. Rest in open tournaments and other rating tournaments, we are using normal clocks only. That time, even partial also can't see that one. So, we have to run.
It's a good way to keep yourself fit.
Yeah. And many, what happens if they want to go for restroom or drinking water? So, here only 14 and parents are there, they will support us. But in open tournament, he'll ask for volunteers also, because many are want to go to washrooms and then for drinking water. Sometimes they will serve tea. So for that also. And even in visually challenged tournaments, they are not taking entry fees. They're not collecting entry fees and they're giving boarding and lodging freely.
For all tournaments?
For open rating tournaments, for all tournaments. Even open tournaments, like there is not, if it is not a rating tournament, there also they're not collecting entry fees. They are only giving boarding and lodging freely.
So All India Chess Federation of Blind collects no entry fees?
No, even organizer also not collects.
Wow.
There is no fees, only they will collect if it is a rating tournament. Official fees, that is 250 rupees for All India Chess Federation and for 50 rupees for All India Chess Federation for the blind, they are collecting for year. And that will be maximum they will collect on South Zone tournament and in open rating tournament. If other open tournaments, there also they are not going to collect 50 rupees for ASFP and this thing.
I saw at this event that at one point you were also changing the water bottle, like this big can. So I realized that being a chief arbiter in open tournament is a matter of pride, you know, they move with lot of authority, while here it is more like you have to do more work if you are a chief arbiter.
That only I am telling, because in working in normal, that is in normal tournaments, I will also work as a chief arbiter in many tournaments. I am also a B-grade arbiter, international arbiter. Lastly, I worked in Ahmedabad for Olympiad and also in Under 11 Nationals at Pune. I would like to thank ASCF and All India Chess Federation. They are giving opportunities, because here, see what happens, we are not only arbiter. During the game, we are arbiters, we are following the FIDE rules, all are correct. But sometimes we need some humanity and also, see, that's why I said, I am feeling happier to work and serve. I'm not arbiter here. When game starts, I'll work as an arbiter. If need, I'll use my service also for them. Yeah, but regarding rules and regulation, there is no question of.
And you have been serving blind chess now for nearly 9 years, yeah? So from 2009.
Yeah.
So do you see any growth in chess and the number of players and the interest levels?
Yeah, sure. Because when first I entered to 2009, there was around 80 players only from all over the country. Now around, I think, only 10 or 15 rated players were there maximum, I think so. But now around 150 or 160 rated players are there. And many schools and blind educations are supported by these blind societies and like this, they are supporting for chess. Previously, many tournaments were conducted in Mumbai only. And there was no other sponsors and nobody was willing. Now in Gujarat, there is an association. And in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Kerala, and everywhere they are conducting tournaments. Even National B was conducted in Haryana. Like that, now blind chess is popularizing and also they are trying to do their best. But it's a bit difficult because it's not a spectator game and there is no, what do you call, publicity will not be there more. So then, sponsor will not come forward to some, okay, now they are trying their level best. And I would like to thank ChessBase India for supporting this nationally, because otherwise ASCFB was very much worried what to do. They don't know how to conduct the event. Even they asked us first before starting this what we had to do. Then I said, Charu sir, we have to conduct the tournament. We are announced and July there is a world team tournament in Bulgaria. So we can't postpone the tournament, but we have to do it. Just think over it. Then whatever is possible, if necessary, we can reduce the budget and these things, and we can do it in minimum cost.
Right. Thank you so much for this. And there's one thing. What would be your message to the Indian budding arbiters community? Because you know the number of arbiters in India is also growing. So what would be your message for them? And do you think they should also get involved in the activities of blind?
Yeah, but now I thought that many are interested. Like that in Delhi, Guru Dayal is worked for one tournament, Biswanath Banerjee is worked, and in Tamil Nadu, I think Ephraim and one more worked for blind chess. Just my request is, if there is a local tournaments or local associations are there, they can involve with that, and they can ask them to conduct the tournament. Okay, I'm not telling work freely or like that. They can just give suggestions, and if newcomers are coming, at least once in a year or twice in a year, they can conduct one tournament. So it will be helpful for players and also Blind Chess Association and also Blind Chess Players.
And they will get a lot of mental satisfaction.
Yeah, definitely. See, once I asked Biswanath Banerjee and Gurudayal how you felt when you conducted the tournament. Gurudayal said, sir, it's very difficult to conduct there, we will be very soft. Then I said, don't be soft. Okay, you are soft with the person, but not with the game or not with the rules. See, because I found that in my experience, many visually challenged players also, they are making some moves intentionally. That is, they want to take the advantage of that visually challenge, that, like that. So then we said, no, sometimes we must be rude only, but we must be polite maximum time. Sometimes if they need the time, need that the person who is in front of you, if you feel that he's good and he's not cheating, then okay. But sometimes you can observe that he's cheating intentionally, you want to take the advantage of blindness. There must be, you follow the rule and you must be rude.
Definitely much more challenging than normal chess. You have to stay alert all the time.
Yeah.
So great job, Manjunath, and we congratulate you for your contribution to blind chess.
Thank you.